गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द फर्स्ट चैप्टर इन आवर फिजिक्स रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ लाइट एट कार्बन सरफेसेस। रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ लाइट एट कार्बन सरफेसेस। सो बिफोर गोइंग टू बी लर्न अबाउट द रिफ्लेक्शन वी शुड हैव नो व्हाट डज मीन बाय लाइट। What is mean by light? So, light is also a form of energy. Light is a form of energy which is emitted by luminous bodies such as sun, burning candle, etc. Here, light is a form of energy which is emitted by the luminous bodies such as sun, burning candle, etc. Here I am using a word called as luminous bodies. What does mean by luminous bodies? The bodies which emits the light, by its own. So the bodies which emits the light by its own are called as luminous bodies. So a natural source is nothing but sun, burning candle also we will get the light. And then next, light is an electromagnetic in nature. Light is an electromagnetic in nature. So why I am saying an electromagnetic in nature means, for example, if you have seen the sound, we have taken sound. Sound is also a form of energy. Sound is also a form of energy, but sound can travel through solids, liquids and gases. If we consider the sound energy, sound is also a form of energy, but it can travel through solids, liquids and gases. Sound can travel through solids, liquids and gases, and it cannot travel in vacuum. It cannot travel in vacuum. If we are taking the sound, sound is also a form of energy. It can travel travels through solids, liquids, gases, and but it cannot travel through the vacuum. Whereas if we are taking the light, light is electromagnetic in nature, so it does not require any media to travel. So light does not require any media to travel. That's why we are saying it as electromagnetic in nature. Means light can travel through not only in solids, liquids and gases. Light not only travels through the solids, liquids and gases, but it can also travels through vacuum. Here, if you are taking the sound energy, sound can travel through only solids, liquids and gases. It cannot travel through the vacuum. But if you are taking light energy, light can travel not only through the solids, liquids and gases, it can also be travels through the vacuum. That's what we are saying it as an electromagnetic in nature. So let us come to the next point. Here, if anything is traveling from one place to another place, when it is moving from one place to another place, means it should have some speed or velocity. It should have some speed or velocity. So here we are saying that light is traveling not only in liquid, solids and gases, it also travels through the vacuum, we are saying. Means light is traveling, means it is having some speed. Therefore, speed of light is nearly 3 lakh kilometers per second in vacuum or air intake. The speed of light is nearly 3 lakh kilometers per second in vacuum or air, which is equal to 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. Speed of light is nearly 3 lakh kilometer per second in vacuum or air, so which is equals to 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. Whereas speed of light is nearly 2.5 lakhs kilometer per second in glass, so which is equals to 2.5 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. So the speed of light is 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meters per second in vacuum, whereas the speed of light is 2.5 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second in glass. If you have observed here, the speed of light, whenever it is traveling from vacuum to glass, the speed of light is varying. So why the speed of light is varying? For this one characteristic or one property of light is there, that property is refraction, that we will study in the next chapter. Now, once again we will revise. Light is a form of energy which is emitted by the luminous bodies such as sun, burning candle, etc. Here, the luminous bodies means the bodies which emits the light by its own are called as luminous bodies. If we are taking the light, light is an electromagnetic in nature. Because electromagnetic in nature, so it does not require any media to travel. Means light can travel not only through the solids, liquids and gases, it also travels through the vacuum. Whereas sound cannot travel through the vacuum. And then if you are taking the next point, speed of the light is 3 lakh km per second in vacuum or air, which is equals to the 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. Whereas the speed of light is nearly 2.5 lakhs kilometers per second, which is equals to the 2.5 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. And here the next thing, light exhibits both particle nature and wave nature. So light exhibits both particle nature and wave nature. So particle nature of light comes under ray optics, whereas comes under wave optics. So here, whatever we are having in our syllabus, we are learning about the ray optics. We are learning about the ray optics. So in our syllabus, a special name ray optics is not being mentioned. But whatever we are learning in our syllabus is nothing but ray optics. About the wave optics, we doesn't have in our syllabus. That we will see in the lecture. So here, what I am saying, light is exhibiting both particle nature and as well as the wave nature. So here the particle nature of light comes under the ray optics, and whereas the wave nature comes under the wave optics. So for this, first of all, we should have learned about rectilinear propagation of light. So rectilinear propagation of light, nothing but light always travels. Light always travels in straight line direction. Light always travels in straight line direction, which is called as a rectilinear propagation of light. And then these are the assumptions of ray optics. Whatever I am writing, assumption of ray optics, these assumptions of ray optics, the assumptions of ray optics, first one is the rectilinear propagation of light. Rectilinear propagation of light means light always travels in a straight line direction, which is to be called as rectilinear propagation of light. And before that, we should have learned one more principle called as Fermat's principle. About this Fermat principle, already you are having in an 8th class syllabus. Fermat principle is what? The Fermat principle? Light always selects the path which takes least time to travel. Light always selects a path which takes the least time to travel is nothing but the Fermat principle. So if it is selecting a path which takes least time, that's why the light always travels in a straight line direction, which is to be called as a rectilinear propagation of light. This is the first assumption of ray optics. And then next assumption, reflection of light. Now the next assumption is that reflection of light. So before going to be learned about the reflection about the light, for example, if we hit a ball on the wall, then what happens? For example, this is ball, I'm hitting a ball from this side. What happens? Whenever it strikes the ball, automatically it will come back in the opposite direction. Opposite direction from by which angle we have thrown the ball. So here, what happening? Whenever we are hitting a ball on the wall, it is coming back. Means it is bouncing back. So here, reflection of light. Bouncing back of light ray. Bouncing back of light ray when it touches any surface. Bouncing back of light ray when it touches any surface is called as a reflection of light. Is called as reflection of light. Once again, we will revise. Light exhibits the both nature. One is particle nature of the light and other one is a wave nature of light. This, the particle nature of the light is comes under the ray optics, whereas the wave nature of the light comes under the
wave optics. So here we are learning about the assumptions of ray optics. In the assumptions of ray optics, the first one is the rectilinear propagation of light. What is mean by rectilinear propagation of light? So light always travels in the straight line direction, which is to be called as rectilinear propagation of light. So about this we learned one more definition, that is Fermat's principle. Fermat's principle is what? Light always selects the path which takes least time to travel. And then next, reflection of light. So second assumption is nothing but reflection of light. So reflection of light means bouncing back of light ray when it touches any surface is called as reflection of light. For example, here you see if it is a plane mirror. Now if it is an incident ray, what it is called as? Incident ray means what? The ray which is falling on a surface. The ray which is falling on a surface is called as an incident ray. When it strikes the plane mirror, will be bounces back in the opposite direction. This is reflected ray. Reflected ray means bounced back light ray is called as reflected ray. Incident ray, the ray which is falling on any surface is called as incident ray. Bounced back light ray from a surface is called as reflected ray. And here the perpendicular line is called as normal. So this is the normal is nothing but perpendicular line drawn to the surface at point of contact. This perpendicular line we are drawing from the point of contact. So this is to be called as normal, and this is the incident ray, this is the normal, and this is the reflected ray. Here we are getting an angle. If we take an A, B, C, A, B, N. Here we are getting some angle. So this angle is called as angle of incidence. And here from means angle made by the incident ray and the normal is called as angle of incidence, and angle made by the normal to the reflected ray is called as angle of reflection. Here if we consider this as a plane mirror, AB is the incident ray and whereas BC is the reflected ray and BN is the normal. Here I am writing AB is incident ray and BC is reflected ray, BN is normal. Angle ABN is angle of incidence and angle LBC is angle of reflection. angular reflection. So this is the second assumption of ray optics. So here AB is representing the incident ray, BC is representing the reflected ray, BN representing the normal. So angle ABN is nothing but the angle of incidence, angle LBC is nothing but the angle of reflection. I remain about this loss of reflection, we'll see in the tomorrow's class. Thank you.